All the friends came running. There were three of them, Atul, Surud and Neha. There were some marbles in their hands. All the marbles had to be distributed equally among them. One marble was given to Atul, one to Neha and the third was taken by Surud. So each of them had one marble. Mother said, now everyone has one marble, so each one has an equal number of marbles. So one part from three is with each of you. If we would have taken three apples instead of three marbles, then you would have got one apple each. Would anyone have got all the three apples? All of them said, no. Surud whispered, I would not mind at all if I would get all the three. Immediately, Atul and Neha shouted, we would strictly object to it. Equal means equal. One marble, one marble, one marble. One apple, one apple, one apple, one cap, one cap, one cap, one ball, one ball, one ball. Each child was given one marble from three marbles. Three apples were equally given, so each got one apple. Three caps were distributed equally among three, and three balls were also distributed equally among the three. What does this mean? Atul said that he did not get all the things, but since everyone got an equal number of things, he did not complain. Among three things, they all got one. Surud was thinking a little more on this. In this game, there was one similarity that each one got one part out of total three, and combining these separate items forms a total number of items. Mother was quite happy. She said, "You all are very clever. If you understand anything properly, then it becomes easy. That is, if you use your brain properly and think well. Now, if you take any three things and you have to distribute them equally, you will be able to do that. So, you will get one third part of the total number of things. You will not get the whole, but you will get it in equal amount. Correct?" All of them nodded their hands. Surud said quietly, "Now the real bowling has begun." Mother said, "This concept of one out of three is not dependent on things like marbles, apples, caps, etc., but is like the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, etc. It does not depend on the object or circumstances. When we say that any object is one out of three, it denotes a number. When we count, we do the same thing. It is first thought about and then used practically. The name and sign that we use can be different in different languages and countries. Even in the same language, there are slightly different names also. But once we decide these signs and the words we use for them, then they are easy to talk, understand, and fun to play around also." Atul was very impatient. "All this is going over my head. Please tell me the names and signs quickly. I want to tease my classmates. They act very proud." But mother explained that it was good to have fun but not good to insult anyone. "Now you will show off the maths sums that you know and maybe others do not know. So you will also be throwing your weight around." Atul looked uneasily and said to mother, "You first tell the specific words and signs please." Everyone laughed. "We have to take one among three. Write three below a horizontal line. And one part taken from it should be written above like this, 1 divided by 3. And then Atul said, if you are given two parts, then how will you write it? It's easy. One line and three below it and two above it, that is 2 divided by 3. Great. All of them shouted in joy. "What do we call this?" "Neha, we need such a name by which we will understand its meaning. A part of the whole is a portion of it. We can say 2/3 quickly. It is two parts of three. The earlier one can be called 1/3. Now tell me something. Suppose there are 5 guavas. There are some guests who will be coming and some guavas need to be given to them. If I give you one guava each, then what portion did you get? What is that fraction?" Atul thought for a moment and then said, "First we should draw a line." Neha was going to the next step, but mother stopped her. She said, "Atul should give the complete answer. If someone else says the answer and he keeps silent, then just agrees to it, it is not a good thing at all. This kind of trick will not do. He is naughty, but still likes to study. So, Atul started explaining again. First, we should draw a horizontal line. Then, we should write the total number below it, that is 5. And how much number is received should be written above it. 1 divided by 5. Great, great. So, this will be 1 among 5, that is 1/5. Now, go and do your homework. Atul said, homework is done. Neha was thinking. She said, when did you complete? I completed it here only at home. Everyone laughed. When all the friends met again the next day, then Atul said, you know, uncle, mother served me 2 pieces of 1/4 chapati. I understood 1/4 is 1 out of 4 pieces of 1 chapati. But mother said that she served me half chapati. But half is 1/2 of the chapati. She served me 1/4 plus 1/4 chapati. So that it became 1 divided by 2. I know this is correct, but uncle said that maths that Atul learned has been used practically. This is a good thing. He had a question regarding this, and that too is a really good thing. Atul immediately asked, uncle, how about a gift then? Everyone, including uncle, laughed. Keep down a chapati. Keep a 1/4 piece of chapati on it. Take another piece of 1/4 chapati and join it with the previous one. So now the total chapati eaten is half. Now 4 pieces of chapati which are 1/4 will together make 1 whole chapati. Now we took 2 parts from 4. So half 1/2 is the fraction we use. Correct? But you know there is some fun ahead. I was still feeling hungry. So mother served me 2 1/4 chapati pieces. So 1 chapati was eaten completely. If mother would have given me half chocolate and later on 1 part of the chocolate divided into 3 parts, then how much chocolate did I get? Let us have a look at the figure given below to understand this. In the first figure, the chocolate is divided into 2 parts. In the second figure, the chocolate is divided into 3 parts. The first fraction is 1/2 and the second is 1/3. So, we have to calculate 1 divided by 2 plus 1 divided by 3. So, how do we do this? Neha replied immediately. Let us make the denominators equal in some way. Surud added without changing the fraction. Uncle patted them and said that first chocolate has been divided into 2 and the second chocolate into 3 parts. So, if we divide 1 divided by 2 into 3 equal parts and 1 divided by 3 into 2 equal parts, then these parts will match. Let us see how. There will be 6 equal parts. 1/2 equal to 3/6 and 1/3 equal to 2/6. So, 1 divided by 2 plus 1 divided by 3 equal to 3 divided by 6 plus 2 divided by 6 equal to 3 plus 2 divided by 6 equal to 5 divided by 6. In the above figure, 1/2 is colored dark blue and 1/3 is filled with chocolate color. Among 6, 5 parts are colored. So we can add in this way. Even if the sum is more than 1, there is no problem. For example, 2 divided by 3 plus 3 divided by 5. Here, we should divide 1 into 3 multiplied by 5 equal to 15 parts. 1 means 15 parts. 2 divided by 3 means 2 multiplied by 5 parts out of 15. 2 divided by 3 equal to 10 divided by 15. 3 divided by 5 means 3 into 3 parts out of 15. 3 divided by 5 equal to 9 divided by 15. The denominator is now same, that is 15. Now we have to add the parts in numerators. In 2/3 there are 10 parts and in 3/5 there are 9 parts. That adds to 19. But 19 is more than 15. 15 parts make up 1 and 4 remains. So the answer is 1 complete and 4/15. Everyone was very happy. They understood that what seemed a very difficult subject was actually quite easy. They shouted at each other in fun and ran outside.